The history of Oliver Goldsmith is one so compelling that I quit a relatively good job. I just kind of like the idea of, you know, bringing this craftsmanship back to eyewear. It was a company started in 1926 by my great-grandfather, who decided that glasses were so centric to a person that they should be more than a medical necessity. They should be something that you would use to express yourself. And so his starting aim for his company was to create eyewear that you could use to express yourself. You can almost sort of plot a timeline of sort of firsts where Oliver Goldsmith did something that hadn't been done before, starting with my great-grandfather being the first person to find an alternative material, a revolutionary material in the 1930s called plastic. And he was able to source some and create some of the first ever colourful spectacle frames. My grandfather in the late 30s noticed that there was no such thing as sunglasses. I mean, people would take their old spectacles to the jeweller and they'd put some tinted glass in and they were your sunspecs. And so my grandfather thought, maybe if I design something that starts out life to be a sunspec, that could work. And he designed, you know, these kind of bigger, more flamboyant frames, and he took them down to Fortnum and Mason's in London and said, don't pay me for them, just put them out on the shelf and see if they sell. And, you know, a week later they were on the phone saying that they'd sold out and they needed more. So, you know, the first people to kind of create sunglasses as a product category in its own right. We were the first brand to appear in Vogue in 1942. The fashion world then acknowledging that eyewear was a fashion accessory. The people that my grandfather made glasses for, and later on my father and my uncle went on to make glasses for, are people that are so well known for their eyewear. Audrey Hepburn was one of our main sort of wearers. Michael Caine, Peter Sellers, Grace Kelly. We made a couple of pairs of John Lennon specs. Looking at the designs that we still produce today from his archive, from his collection, the fact that they're still as relevant today as they were 50 years ago says to me there was something very pure about his designs. There's just something about my grandfather's whole approach to this business, which was, you know, this isn't medicine, you know, this is fun, this is playful. Uncovering that history sparked something in me that made me ask, why is Oliver Goldsmith not around anymore? And yeah, the only reason at the time was that in 1985, licensing was a really big business and big name brands were what people wanted. But it was 2005 by this point, 20 years on, and I knew that wasn't the case anymore. I just knew that putting this brand back together again was exactly what I should do.